and gentlemen, welcome to Cromwell High School for today's performance of the smash ABBA Broadway hit, Mamma Mia! For the safety and security of today's performance, please take this time to locate one of the four exits in the rear of the auditorium. Due to the very restrictive show rights for Mamma Mia, taking videos, photos, or audio of our performance today is strictly prohibited, and any violations of this copyright law will result in removal from the performance. Please note, today's performance features flashing strobe-like effects, smoke machines, and loud music. Please take any and all precautions if you are sensitive to those added effects. Yeah, this show will feature a 15 to 20 minute intermission, at which time we invite you to the lobby to get snacks, beverages. All proceeds will directly benefit the music and drama students at Cromwell High School. At this time, the cast and crew of Mamma Mia would like to thank all of our program sponsors, parent volunteers, and the Performing Arts Boosters for supporting the show. Without you, this would not be possible. And now, sit back, stretch those vocal cords, and get your dancing shoes on as Cromwell High School proudly presents Mamma Mia!
where have you been? I thought you'd get here hours ago.
What a journey. Guess we'll have to play ticket on the kitchen table.
We said we have to get on this plane. It's our best friend's wedding tomorrow.
We made such a fuss, but you were not getting married without your bridesmaids.
So, where is he? Your sky? We're dying to meet him.
How's Donna?
I bet she's going nuts over this wedding.
I've been dying for you guys to get here. I've got a secret, and you're the only ones I can tell.
Oh my God, are you pregnant?
No! Look, I found this in Mom's desk.
Sophie, you're not supposed to go around reading your mom's diary.
Yeah, she's supposed to go around reading yours.
But look, 1979. It's the one she kept the year she got pregnant with me. You know she won't talk about my dad. She says she doesn't remember it. But look, July 17th. What a night. After the show, Sam rode me over to the island. We danced on the beach, kissed on the beach, and dot, dot, dot.
What?
Dot, dot, dot. It's what they did in the olden days.
Oh!
Sam's the one. I know he is. I've never felt like this before. Yep, the sperm donor has a name. Well, three names. Sam, Bill, or Harry.
And they're all arriving to the wedding.
Yes.
Oh my God, so do they know?
What do you write to a total stranger? Come to my wedding, you might be my dad? No, they think Mom sent the invitations. And after what's in here, I am not surprised they said yes.
Let's hope it's a wide aisle.
We've got to keep Mom out of the picture. She mustn't know what I've done.
So she's bound to see them sooner or later.
I don't want her frightening them off before I've got a chance to know them. If I'm right, I'll know who my dad is as soon as I see him.
And what if you don't?
Then I've got 24 hours to find out. Thank you.
Oh my God! How much further are these stinking stilettos? What were you expecting? A chauffeured limousine at the water's edge? Yes, Donna knows I don't do walking.
Well, were you looking with the tide wash then?
For one night and one night only. Donna
and the tide wash!
So how is the mother of the bride? Much better for seeing the two of you.
God, Tanya, 8 friggin' years.
I know, honey, I'm sorry. It's just been one jet-setting millionaire after another.
And I could change this place. The constant battle with the bank manager.
I pity the poor bank manager.
Auntie Rosie! Sophie Sheridan! You get more gorgeous every time I see you. I came all this way for your wedding.
I bet you don't remember me.
All that plastic surgery.
Of course I do, Auntie Tanya.
Look at my baby. Her whole life is ahead of her.
I'm getting married, Mom. I'm not joining a convent.
I know. It's just in my name you didn't get married at 20.
Donna, why do you didn't get married, period?
A white wedding. Can you believe this? I don't know where she gets it from.
Well, don't blame me, Donna. It wasn't my idea.
Ladies, meet the leading man tomorrow night, shindig. Sky, this is Tanya and Rosie. My one-time backup fan and all-time best pal.
Backup fan, my ass. Hello.
Hi, I've heard lots about you two.
All that, I hope.
Yasu Kuklamu, Kazi said.
F. Karisto, Poli De Kepota.
Don't bother. He doesn't speak Greek. The name's Eddie. Bonjour, madame.
Bonjour, Eddie. Enchanté de votre croissance.
Bon appétit.
They call me Pepper.
Why? Because you're hot.
Maybe because he gets up your nose.
Shut up!
Tanya, meet Pepper and Eddie, my bar staff, waiters, boatmen, and general help. Only they're generally no help at all. Don't you two have any work to do?
Honey, the taverna looks fabulous.
We've got skydiving for that.
Why? What have you been up to?
You haven't been here long, have you?
No, I took a break from stocks and bonds and never went back.
Why?
I had enough. I've been dealing in the world, but I've never seen the world.
Well, you should see what he's done to my world. He's got me online, emailed, wired up, and knuckled down.
You gotta move with the times, Donna. No more drachmas under the mattress.
Just invent me a machine that'll make the beds.
Please, Mom, if there was one, I know you'd be right behind it making them all over again.
Are you kidding? I'll be more than ready to put my feet up when my boat comes in.
Speaking of boats, you might want to sink that old wreck more by the jetty.
Sink it?
Well, it's a bit of an eyesore, isn't it?
That eyesore's my floating casino.
What?
Sky and Eddie are transforming it into a millionaire's paradise.
Sailing around the islands, gambling under the stars.
Gambling millionaires? Maybe a few of your ex-husbands, Tanya?
I don't think so, honey. I spent the millions.
Well, girls, this is my jackpot. I need a break. I need a vacation. I've been working here for 15 years, and I've never had a day off.
I work all night, I work all day to pay the bills I have to pay.
Thank you.
Oh man, I sure am glad to get off that boat.
Oh, that was nothing. You should try kayaking the Okavango swamps.
Oh yes, I read your book. A bloke in a boat in Botswana.
Oh, thanks, Harry. I heard I sold a copy somewhere.
Yeah, well, travel books are my passion. A distraction from the daily rigors of the London rush hour.
Do you two want to hear something interesting? You see this taberna?
Yes, I'm quite impressed. I remember an old hut here. I was dreading bedding down with the goats.
Oh, but give the goats before camels. There was this one time in the Kalahari, the sun was beating.
Sorry to interrupt. ATM. But the point is, this is my taberna. I built it. Well, I designed it. Drew up the plans, what, 21 years ago? I can't believe she's actually gone and built the damn thing.
Oh,
Donna, who else? This was something I scribbled on the back of the menu. I have no idea.
Well, how do you know it's yours?
Buildings are like babies. You always know your own.
I wouldn't know about babies. I've been living out of a backpack all my life.
Oh, the happy wanderer, eh? Do you think this island will inspire some prose?
I hope so. When I got the invitation, I sold my editor a piece on childhood haunts revisited.
Well, you won't hear.
I was born in the U.S., but my mother's Greek. No, the only time I came back was to visit my great aunt on the mainland, and that was 21 years ago.
So now you can write about Sam Starburner and the tourists will flock.
No, I think the island should remain the secret idol I've always remembered it as.
Yes, but if you lived here, maybe the idol would be the boatload of tourists with the big bucks.
Well, at least they might have some staff then. Where's everybody?
Hello, can I help you?
Yes, I'm Bill Austin. You have room for me?
Bill Austin?
I'm Bright. Harry Bright.
Harry Bright? So you must be...
Sam Carmichael. You are expecting us?
Yeah, I'll go get the keys.
Charming. Well, I do hope I get the chance to wrap my tongue around a little Greek. I haven't spoken it in 21 years.
21 years? You know, this is all beginning to feel like some sort of set. Bill, here's a story for you. Three men, strangers, receive an invitation to a wedding. They're invited to a place they haven't seen in 21 years by a woman they haven't seen in 21 years. Why are they here?
You know, that's not bad. Okay, Harry, spill. What's torn you away from the Bank of England?
Is this an interview? Okay, well, for me, Donna's invitation brought back many happy memories. Bloody Nora!
Is that a quote?
No, I know this guitar. D.S. Donna Sheridan, an H.B. headbanger! That's what they used to call me in the old days. I bought this for her. 10 quid in my Johnny Rock t-shirt. Now, who says I'm an old unadventurous stick in the mud?
Who?
My other half. Big house, fast car, and a season ticket to the Chelsea Football Club isn't enough for some people, is it? They want the Great White Hunter, too. Well, I can do spontaneity. I was an exchange student in Paris when we met. I just followed her to Greece. Spontaneously. Thank you for the music, the songs I'm singing. Thanks for all the joy they're bringing. Who can live without it? I ask in all honesty. What would life be without a song? Or that's what are we? So I say thank you for the music, for giving it to me.
Your doctor?
Yes.
Wow.
I look familiar. Sophie. Sophia. No, Sophia's the Greek. I had a great aunt, Sophia.
It's named after her, Sophia.
Where's Donna? I want to talk to her. Thank her for the invitation.
Yes, it's quite nice of her to remember us.
You can't. I sent the invitations. Mom doesn't know.
But why?
Well, Mom's always talking about her friends from the old days, so I figured she'd be thrilled if I invited them all. But she's got herself in such a state about this wedding, mentioned unexpected guests, and she'll hyperventilate.
So, hold on. Are you telling me Donna didn't invite me?
No, she didn't. So, pretend you're here for a holiday. She'll get a lovely surprise when she sees you at my wedding and we can let her know the secret.
But, so...
She says I need it.
don't want to spoil your lovely surprise, but the last time I saw your mother, she told me she never wanted to see me again. So if you're the one who sent the invitation, I'm still mad.
But that was years ago. I want you here.
Why?
Because it's my wedding, and I want us all to be friends.
You're just a little minx. Worse than your mother. I'm glad you haven't met my boys.
Your boys? You have sons?
Yes, I have two. God, I'd love to bring them here someday.
Like you used to bring my mother?
I'm here on one of my spontaneous holidays.
Thought I'd just drop in.
Oh dear, what a shame we don't have any rooms. It's that time of the year.
Just as well. I booked ahead. You two can room down with me if they're really full.
This is so inconvenient.
Why?
Because one of the local girls is getting married tomorrow, and I just don't have the staff to cope with you. You'd be much more comfortable on the mainland.
Not at all. Bill's used to suffering for his art. Headbanger over there is the last word in spontaneous.
What about you?
I came here to see the island. You know what it meant to me.
Well, I'd love to stop and chew over old times, but I have to go and clean my purse.
Age cannot wither her.
I was expecting a funky little housewife.
Nope, she's still back.
Shoulder you can cry on.
dad.
Who's dad?
Sophie's. You know I always said it was Sam, the architect, went home to get married.
Bastard. Typical man.
Well, I'm not really sure if it was him. You see, there were a couple of others.
Donna Sheridan, you dark horse!
Why didn't you tell us? I didn't think I'd ever have to. I didn't think all three of them would be sitting at my bar the day before my daughter's wedding.
What? At the bar? Don't let them see you!
I can't see anyone. Who are they?
Are you sure?
Of course I'm sure. It's Sam, Bill Austin, and Harry Hedman.
Not...
Why have they all turned up like this? It's like some horrible twist of fate.
Well, it is very Greek. Do they know?
They can't know. I've never told anyone. Why are they here to ruin Sophie's wedding?
Donna, I thought you were too keen on this wedding.
I don't want them spoiling it. They have no right to turn up like this. What have they ever done for their daughter?
Donna, be fair. They didn't know she existed.
And they don't need to know. I've done a damn good job with soap all by myself. And now I'm going to be muscled out by an ejaculation.
No, you're not. You're seated at Sophie's party. It's a male-free zone. And tomorrow, Tanya and I will take them fishing. Fishing? Oh, please. Well, what do you suggest we do with three men? Now that takes me back.
Oh, Donna, you should have told us. I remember Bill Austin. He was a hot slice of beefcake. Oh. I'm sure it's a laughing memory for you two, but I'm the one who got pregnant. I guess this just about serves me right.
Oh my God, you sound just like your mother.
I do not.
Yes, you do. Whatever happened to our Donna, life and soul of the party, El Rock Chick Supremo?
She grew up, that's all.
Well, grow back down again. You have nothing to be ashamed of.
Yeah, screw them if they can't take a joke.
Friday night in the lights.
Oh, hello. Well, the guys haven't told me yet, but there's lap dancers at the Orpheus Bar, mud wrestlers at Medusa's, and Pepper's bringing his handcuffs.
Don't go.
What? I missed out on my last night of freedom?
No, I don't mean don't go. I mean, wait. Is that really how you see it?
Yeah. No, I see it as the last night before the biggest adventure of my life. Come here.
You know how I said I wanted to find my dad?
Oh, Sophie, we've been through this thousands of times. You don't need your dad. I'm here.
Whatever happens, you'll never leave me, will you?
Are you crazy? You've turned my world upside down.
I wasn't jealous before we met. Now every man that I see is a potential threat. And I'm possessive, it isn't nice. You've heard me say that smoking was my only vice. But now it isn't true. Now everything is new. And all my work has overturned. I beg of Oh,
and one night only, the Summer Night Taverna is proud to present the world's girl power band live before you in all its grown-up, wrinkly glory.
Speak for yourself.
One night,
one number.
That's all they've got the breath for.
Give it up for
Donna and the Dynamo!
priest, and to burn him. I always meant to come back and build this someday, but Donna, she beat me too.
Do you always prefer buildings to people?
What?
Well, tell me something about my mom.
She was irresistible. One of a kind. We talked and we fought. You do know it was me who brought her to the side.
That wasn't all you did, was it?
What she told you?
That's nothing. She's never mentioned you.
But you said Mom's always talking about her friends with the old days. What's going on, Sophie? Why am I here?
Sophie, this hasn't been my secret.
Yeah. father?
I think so.
You know what that means?
Well, don't tell me you've got a twin sister.
Will you give me away tomorrow?
Give you away?
I'll feel like a proper bride when I walk down the aisle with my father.
I'll find your mother.
Not tonight. We can't let her know until the wedding.
She'll go crazy.
She'll be relieved. She'll see us together and she'll be happy we're happy.
All right, I'll do it.
Come on, guys, the boys are coming.
Take a 15-minute intermission, at which time you can visit our Music Parents Association snack booth for some treats and more. Thank you.
Okay. Perfect. Okay. 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 Okay.
What's going on? What are you doing at 6 o'clock in the morning?
I don't know.
Wait right there.
Mom, I'm all right.
Of course you're not all right. You're sleepwalking again.
Again? When did I ever sleepwalk?
The night you came down from measles, the time you could finish.
Mom, get off. I'm not a baby.
I know, Soph, but you're still my daughter, and I can tell something is bothering you. It can't be stopped. It's not too late. You can sort out the wedding shenanigans.
Shenanigans? What do you mean by shenanigans?
I'm sorry. It's just a figure of speech.
No. That's what you think, isn't it? That I'm stupid to get married. It's just a whim.
Well, I'm not pretending I understand.
Of course you don't. You did just fine without a man, didn't you? You didn't do the whole marriage and babies thing. Just did the baby.
What the hell are you talking about? Why are you coming down on me?
I'm going to do it right. I love Sky more than anyone else in the world. Besides, I don't want my kid growing up not knowing who their father is, because it's crap.
Jesus, will you stop that racket before you wake the whole island? And where did you get that monstrosity?
Oh, they're not that bad. Oh, you mean this? I found it in the basement. It's the perfect thing for wedding. Is it yours?
No, it's... In what sort of wedding do you think there's going to be at the state of you for? Sky, you're not marrying my daughter smelling like a frat house. Hit the tub. And where do you think you're going?
Scrub the groom's back?
Oh, no, you're not. I want the champagne on ice, the ouzo in the punch bowl, lay out the tablecloths, cutlery, and the best glasses. You'll have to wash and polish them first. Eddie, get your boat.
Why?
Because the guests want to go dive down to the old wreck to search for more pearl necklaces.
But we planted the one Sky found last night.
I don't care. It'll keep them busy until the wedding starts. For God's sake, just do it.
For God's sake.
My dream. Remember? This place, the taverna. My dream.
Well, this is my reality. Hard work and a crippling mortgage.
Would you like me to take a look at that roof? It won't last the winter.
I can fix my own damn roof.
Okay, fine. Be a mother. I've got kids too. know it's hard for you doing it on your own.
Don't you patronize me. I love doing it on my own. I thank Christ every morning I don't have some middle-aged menopausal man to bother me. I'm single, I'm free, and it's great.
Don't worry, doll. I'm no good lawyer.
Why are we talking about my jack?
Yeah, well, I think I'll head back to my room. Too much sun.
Harry, please don't go.
Let's catch up tonight.
Tanya, why don't we catch up from last night?
I've drawn a veil over last night. Last night never happened. Pepper, cha-cha, champagne cocktails all around.
There's the bar, help yourself.
You have to do it. We are guests now.
She just can't find good help these
days. Is that all you caught? Oh,
you should see the one that got away.
It was this big.
Bill, don't exaggerate. It was this big.
Drink, Bill?
Thanks, but no thanks. Rose here's already promised me the works.
I have?
Oh, yes. You know I always keep your whole woman cookbook in my backpack.
You do? Well, then, you'll know how to pepper my snapper.
Good God! 3 hours to blast off! Come on, girls, we've got work to do.
Work?
On my face, sweetie, a little repair and renovation.
You don't want to mess with a masterpiece.
God, he is so tragic.
Yeah, I'll live, no service.
Don't listen to him, Tanya. He can't help being a jerk.
Tanya can have ignored the chemistry between us.
Honey, hold my chair. Little boys who play with fire, get their fingers burnt.
What's happened?
It's a mess, and it's all my fault. I know I shouldn't have, but
I read my mom's diary and turns out I've got 3 possible dads.
Oh my God.
I know I shouldn't have, but I invited them all to come to our wedding. I thought I'd know which one was my dad as soon as I saw him, but I didn't. And now all 3 of them are coming to the wedding and they all expect to give me away.
Wait a minute, go back a bit. You did what?
I invited my dads to come to our wedding. It was 3 months ago. I wasn't even sure they'd come.
3 months?
Look, you have to help me.
Why didn't you tell me?
I knew you wouldn't like it.
I thought we told each other everything. I thought we had trust. But you went behind my back for some stranger.
It wasn't like that.
Is that what this big white wedding's for? Set up so you can find your dad?
No, it's not like that at all.
I wanted to take a boat to the mainland and get married with a couple of witnesses. But you insisted on this big fantasy wedding so you could play happy family.
It's about knowing who I am. I want to get married knowing who I am.
That doesn't come from knowing who your dad is, Sophie. That comes from you. How would you feel if I lied to you? I was marrying you because I loved you and I thought that's what you wanted. But now, I just don't know anymore.
You don't know if you love me?
I don't know if it's what you really want.
Sorry, I interrupted.
No, listen, you think about it.
Sky, wait.
What's going on?
Nothing. Excuse me.
Let him go. He's right. You need to be sure what you really want.
This has got nothing to do with you.
I'm your dad, Sophie. I can't give you away unless I know you're really happy.
I've had this conversation before. With my mother. She knows me a lot better than you do.
What does Donna the Dynamo know about marriage? Or divorce? Listen. I've got 20 years of good advice to cram into 2 minutes, so hear me out. You're so young, Sophie. You've got your whole life ahead of you.
Not now, Sam.
I still remember pleading with my wife.
Breaking up is never easy, I know, but I have to go. Knowing me, knowing best I can do. Knowing me, knowing you.
get anything right. Come in. Harry, what are you doing here?
I wanted to give you this.
I don't mean here. I mean here on this island.
Please.
Holy shit, what's this?
Well, I thought you might have had to tighten your belt a little bit over the past couple of years, raising Sophie on your own, so I wanted to contribute a little something to the wedding.
This could cover 4 weddings and a funeral. Harry, it's a lovely gesture.
Do you remember the last time you said that to me?
No.
It was the night I bought you that guitar. I can remember thinking, oh, those are the last words I'll ever hear from Donna Sheridan. And I always choose.
Oh, Harry, it's a lovely gesture, but...
You're just making that up. I'm sure I said thank you nicely like a well-brought-up Catholic girl.
Oh, well, that's better. That's the first time I've heard you laugh since I've gotten on this island.
A bit stressed, Harry. What do you expect?
Well, a bit more of the old Donna. A bit less of the well-brought-up Catholic.
To
and running a business all on her own.
I didn't have much choice, did I? An unmarried mom in the 70s? I couldn't very well go back home. My mother disowned me.
What? I didn't know that.
It was a damn good thing, too. I'd rather be here than some old depressing housing project. Look at you.
Thank you.
I don't know where I am. I don't know who I am. I just came here for a wedding. I'm Sophie's dad.
Whoa! You need a conversation with Donna.
Yes, I'll go tell her now.
Oh, you'll do no such thing! Sophie's getting married in like 5 minutes! Take a seat and button it.
Will it be all right for me to be here?
Oh, for God's sake!
Well, I'll tell you the truth. I was coming over all faint at the thought of a wedding.
Tell me about it.
Marriage, children, responsibility. I made my mind up long ago. I walk a lone path.
If you change your mind, I'm the first in line. Honey, I'm still free. Take a chance on me. If you need me, let me know. I'm gonna be around. If you've got no place to go when you're feeling down, if you're all
alone. Yeah. excited. Welcome, welcome to Sophie and Sky and all of your friends who have gathered here today, and especially to Donna, who represents your family. Dearly beloved, we are gathered
here- And welcome to Sophie's dad.
What?
I can't keep it from you any longer. I have to tell you, he is here.
I know.
What?
I invited him.
But you couldn't have. I don't know which one of them it is. Oh my God, that's why they're all here.
I'm really sorry, Mom. Will you ever forgive me?
Will you ever forgive me?
I don't care if you've slept with hundreds of men. You're my mom, and I love you.
Oh, Sophie. I haven't slept with hundreds of men.
Hold it. Am I getting this right? Sophie might be mine. She might be Bill's or Harry's.
Yes, that's right. And don't get all self-righteous on me. You only have yourself to blame.
What?
If you hadn't dumped my mom and gone off and married some other woman.
It wasn't like that. I was engaged and I had to go back. I thought it was the right thing to do, but I came back.
What?
I told Lorraine I couldn't marry her and I came back.
Why didn't you call me?
Because I was stupid enough to think that you'd be sitting in your room pining for me. Only when I arrived, they told me you were off with some other guy. I went back home. Lorraine told me what an idiot I was and married me just to prove it.
Sorry if I might just cut in for a moment.
Harry, the check, of course.
No, stuff the check, it's yours. Donna, you were the first girl I loved, but you were also the last. There's all types of families, aren't there? Yours is you and Sophie, and mine is me and Nigel. It's great to have a third of Sophie. I never thought I'd even get that much of a daughter.
I agree with Harry. Being a third of your dad is great by me.
Me too.
Typical. You wait 20 years to figure out who your father is, and then three show up at the same time.
Well, we could figure out which one of you is really my father, but I don't need to. I don't care. I've learned something about myself. Sky, let's not get married.
What?
I know you never wanted any of this, and I've got my whole life ahead of me. Let's get off this island and get out of that world.
I love you.
Donna, do I take it the wedding's canceled?
I haven't got a clue what's going on.
Hold on. Why should we waste a perfectly good wedding? How about it, Sheridan? You're going to need someone to boss around on this island of yours.
Are you nuts? I'm not a bigamist.
Neither am I. I'm a divorced man who's loved you for 21 years of my life, and ever since I got to this island, I've been bursting to show you how much. Come on, Donna. It's only the rest of your life.
Thank you.
Oh, Yes, I did. As they used to say back in the day, it was on the line.
There you go.
I'll shut this.
I feel like I need it.
It's liquidy, I felt.
Would you like?